All right, we are back, and this is still Crossfire with Dapo Anishoma. We have Nelson Ekujumi in the studio with us, and we've been talking about issues of national interest. Now, let's quickly take a look, Nelson, at the problem in the military. And when I say in the Nigerian military or in the Nigerian armed forces, let's look at the Air Force, the Navy, the Army. I mean, not quite a week ago, Alex Bade left office, and during his valedictory speech, he made an open statement saying, "I actually took over a military that does not have arms and ammunition to do anything." Now, yesterday, in the world of Minima, Conor Minima, he said something. Let's just quickly listen to this. Immediate past chief of army staff, Lieutenant General Kenneth Minima, had a parting shot for the LITS today. He accused them of using the dreaded Boko Haram sect to advance political, religious, and sectional interests. The former military chief also regretted that the authorities toyed. He said the authorities toyed with the health and vitality of the military through inadequate funding. So undermining,
national security.
Exactly. And then he went further to say, on the Lieutenant General Minima made this catching mark in his valedictory address at the pulling out, held at the commemoration of his retirement from service yesterday. Now, is it possible? Can you comprehend, what has characterized, the Nigerian, how will I put it, the Nigerian military force? Looking across, just take a very close look at the Army, the Air Force, the Navy, especially as it borders around the fight against insurgency in Nigeria. And then we have the chiefs coming out after leaving the office to let Nigerians know how very incapacitated they were in the fight against insurgency. So what were they doing in office?
One, and two, if from what I so picked from what you just, the little piece you just read that now, he also indicted his former boss. Because if you also recall what Alex Bade said also, that the last time they purchased ammunitions was as far back as 2006, and those were few ammunitions. So the issue is, so far in the fight against insurgency, they were saying that, okay, well, the reason why we couldn't, do what we're supposed to was because of ammunition. And later on, they said they bought ammunition. So is it that not buy ammunition?
Now, before your response, Ishoma, there is something that he kept on saying. He was talking about the elite. He still went further to say, according to him, he said the counterinsurgency campaign would have recorded more successes if the elite had supported government efforts. He said the insurgency snowballed into a graver dimension because these people exploited the security challenge to further, further their sectional, religious, and political interests. Who are the elite?
And what interest can be greater or should be greater than that of the nation?
Does that mean they are more powerful than the nation? That's what it simply means. He's saying that there is a cabal, there is a set of people somewhere that we cannot handle. They are so big, they are so mighty that no part of the military, no part of the Nigerian armed forces would and could handle them.
Well, the truth of the matter is that Lieutenant General Kenneth Minima said is not unexpected. You know, even the Bible says, can two walk together?
Except
they agree. You see, we have never gone this low under our military. Let me tell you, in 2013, in 2014, there was a governorship election in Ekiti and Osun State. I was an election observer, and we saw military men in military fatigue, without identification, in hoods.
Camouflage in hoods.
And we raised alarm. You see, these people, honestly, the examination of the rot in the country must also go thoroughly into the military. Because in 2014, the government made a budget of about 20% of the 2014 budget. The budget for defense alone was about 920 something.
Almost 1 trillion.
Almost a trillion naira.
Yes.
So the question which, and They made this almost the same thing in 2013. So the question we should ask is that where did that money go to?
So then, now you probably may agree with me that the probe, the long hand of probe or inquisition, let me put
honestly,
it that way, should go into
like,
the military.
Like the, was it an American senator that said during the furore over the Chibogues, that said if they had known, they would have come in to rescue the girls. They never knew Nigeria had a non-existent government.
So could it? So maybe this could also be the reason why America, the government of America, didn't want to also sell ammunition to the Nigerian military.
This,
or probably didn't even want to help them.
No sane human being.
Could it be that they had information about
power? We want to relate with these people. Because what they were doing, we had the information. It was all over in the media. This same military, you saw situations whereby the military boys were deserting. You saw situations whereby the military boys mutinied against their commanders.
If it's this particular issue, now let's look at the series of court martials.
Yes,
does it mean also for me? Because I mean, you say that these young soldiers who fought or who went to represent Nigeria to defend the unity of the nation, but now they're being charged with insubordination and all of that. Does it mean that those charges leveled against them can no longer stand? Also,
anyway,
by corroboration of the statements of their
is an admission of guilt by their commanders.
Exactly. So that means that
their
they should be discharged and acquitted of those charges.
They should,
ordinarily.
Yes. Because even what Kenneth Minima is saying now, can you imagine? The chief of army staff of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, who is in charge of security, telling us that there were some people who played the political card on national security, that constitutionally all the powers on everyone are giving it to your hands. It shows that that man has desecrated his commission.
Okay, so I want to read out one of the things he said. I may just have to take only a little block of it. He said, we must therefore all unite and support our government.
Yeah.
That is obviously this
current government
administration.
That is insincere.
And security
forces
government. To tackle the current security challenges. Does that also mean that he's also admitting that this administration, so far from what the information he has probably at his disposal, he knows that this government is ready to tackle the issue of insurgency. And to what level now
my concern
is, Shoma,
how come our service chiefs did not speak out when they were in office?
My brother,
how come, I mean, Alex Bade, he himself, Minima, are coming out now to say that we were not funded? We didn't have money. We didn't have ammunition. How come they are coming out now to say that, support, advise the new government to fund the military?
And to recruit people.
We should even ask them this question. You see, right from when the fight against terrorism started under the former government, when they came into office, we knew there was something. And you know that even the Bible says, I'll go into the Bible again, that when the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous? You see, the foundation of the fact was that the government was very, very dishonest. What Alex Bade has said with Kenneth Minima now, I think Nigerians, you ask question that within the February 14th,
the
6 weeks extension, what did they use to achieve that? That means there's that likelihood that these same service chiefs and their commander in chief were the one funding these terrorists to decimate Nigerians, as well as humiliate our security agencies. Because if they are telling us now that the military was underfunded, the military was poorly equipped, don't forget, Governor of Borno State, Kazim Shettima, at a point in time, cried out that the Boko Haram boys were more equipped than the Nigerian military. And it was almost leashed. Even former President Goodluck Jonathan was even threatened on a media chat to withdraw troops. So that those people, it shows to you that the allegation leveled even against the predecessor of Minima, Yejirika, Azubike Yejirika, holds water. That they should be invested. That, an international negotiator, Stephen Davis, alleged that Kenneth Azubike Yejirika, former governor of Borno State,
Modu Sherif,
that they are the ones funding Boko Haram. It shows to you that there's serious problem with the security of this country. You see, I don't think it is enough for us to just allow Minima and Bade, the National Security Advisor, and even their commander now, to go
now,
free. They should be arrested and, you know,
exactly.
Investigated.
I think I align with you there. And then that comes to now say that what the younger officers were saying, that it was more like sending them on a suicide mission.
Mm-hmm. Very well.
You know, because these boys were not equipped to face, you know,
They didn't even join the military to go and commit suicide. They joined the military to go and defend their father's land.
And you
so you don't defend your father's
empty.
It's like sending somebody to the farm to go and use his hand to plow or to, you know,
so,
plant.
I mean, that eventually contributed to many of them who became compromised. They became compromised saying that, hey, you guys, you have to leave where you are because they told us to come and attack that place. Anyway, as a matter of fact, we cannot even attack you guys. We're not coming with anything. So even if you, I mean, because on the long run, you know, I don't know how true this is, but I heard that there was a time, you know, that information leakage, because Bade said it, and it reflected even in Minima's speech,
Bade,
that there were information leakages within,
columnist.
There is no organization that does not have fifth columnist. So somebody should stop lying to us that they are saboteurs. When I was invited to this program,
okay,
I left my house at about 5 a.m. Mm-hmm. so as to get here on time. Mm-hmm. I got here at about 8 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
It would have been foolish of me to now give the excuse that, look, I slept off, or my wife didn't wake me, mm-hmm, or my tire got punctured. You must always factor in all these things
in human endeavors.
Mm-hmm. So this issue of fifth column, is it today that fifth column is
you
started?
You should know that we always exist.
Jesus had 12 disciples. Yes, there was a Judas.
There was a fifth column.
And even before Judas betrayed Jesus, he had already predicted it.
All right.
In
okay.
man's relationship, somebody must always betray.
Let's take this call from Ahmed. Good morning, Ahmed.
Good morning. My name is Ahmed Kayode from Ilorin.
Welcome to CROSSFIRE.
Okay, thank you. I visit you all here.
Thank you.
Thank you for what you have been saying since.
All right.
Country, I think it's only God can help us, this country. Mm. Because if you look at what Alex Bade, former chief of defense staff, was saying, and former chief of army staff, Kenneth Minima, what they were saying, I think it's too late for them. And if you look at it in second angle, isn't too late. Mm. So what I want this president do is that to let us know where all the money they have been budgeted for them,
mm-hmm,
since Yala era, the president, Jonathan, former president.
Mm-hmm.
Let us know where the money are going to. I mean, where the money was went to.
Mm-hmm.
And let us know how the judgment will come against them. So, but this kind of thing, we used to hear the thing from the beginning. When the thing will conclude, we know anything about the issue again. Look at what former CBN governor, President Emir of Kano, was saying, that out of National House of Assembly, they are the one, maybe they are collecting 75% of our budget or 25%. I don't remember. So they didn't do anything on it till now. And the allegation that he made that time, say 20 billion was missing in our account. We didn't hear anything. And President Muhammadu Buhari, that is here present now. So the wind that is blown now, you understand, new thing. So
right.
The fear of him is making things in order. But I want him to Hello, are you with me?
Yeah, please, yes. But wrap up your, uh-huh, your comments.
So we want him to start at now so that
all right, then.
Nigeria will be good. So thank you very much.
Thank you all so right. much, Ahmed. Thank you. Now, I have an issue. With all of these beautiful cleanups, which is ongoing in the nation, how well is our judiciary equipped to, you know, battle this head on? Because if you look at the judiciary, especially the issue about, you know, adjournment and cases taking forever, you know, it's one of the issues that has discouraged Nigerians. Nigerians find it difficult to have faith in the judiciary. So with all of this now, you know, is there anything that the president probably is trying to put, some mechanisms he's trying to put on ground to make sure, making sure that the judiciary begin to attack cases as spontaneous as they can?
No, you see, the issue of the judiciary is not the responsibility of Mr. President.
Okay.
Mr. President is the one heading the executive arm of government.
Exactly. So he can,
the judiciary has,
well,
we have a chief.
He can do,
we have the, no, it depends on the caliber the and the competence of the chief justice of the federation, as well as the competence of the people who are in the National Judicial Commission. So they should be the ones to do the house cleaning.
But a little pep talk from Mr. President.
No, yeah, Mr. President could. Mr. President
could. I mean, the best he can do would be
is a pep talk. Yeah, but
no,
I think
he would advise
necessary.
He would advise the head of the judiciary, who is the chief justice of the federation, you know, to bring their demands, their requests that can, you know, help clean the organ stable in the judiciary. Because whether we like it or not, what you have just said is very, very
key.
Much
it's very key.
Realistic.
Because on the long run,
that
if
we will need somebody,
yeah. But against the military, I think it's going to be in the military court. I mean,
the
it doesn't
show.
No,
yeah.
It won't be only
no,
the military court because
no.
It's a violation
very
of
true.
The Constitution.
Very
it will also be in the
and we're talking about
civil court. Because if a military man is
also.
Caught stealing or is alleged to have violated the offense, even though there will be an in-house discipline for him, he also is liable to be prosecuted in the civil courts.
Court.
So these civil service chiefs and their commander-in-chief, I think it is we should start calling on Mr. President
to immediately
get them arrested. And they should be made to answer for whatever
they
did.
Whatever they have done. All right, let's quickly go on a short break. When we come back, we'll be approaching the last lap of CROSSFIRE, and we'll still be discussing about issues, you know, on national interests. We'll be right back. We are back. Yesterday, Nigerian former chief of army staff, Lieutenant General Kenneth Minima, yesterday he said he accused the country's elite of using Boko Haram, you know, terrorists to advance their selfish interest. I'm still asking, Nelson, who are these people?
I think we should ask the man who made the statement.
Ah.
No, it's the truth. Because the man has the constitutional powers.
And his emphasis throughout the speech was so clear that he has a picture in his head.
Yes.
He's talking about some particular
so those elites, he's an intelligence chief, he's chief of
army
staff.
He knows them.
So he knows them. So he must be called to come and name those elites that he's mentioning. You see, some of these people, it's like they don't reason when they make their comments. Because or they don't realize the import. Maybe they were not qualified to be on that seat. Because I don't expect a chief of army staff to come out and tell us that there were some people sabotaging the efforts of the military. So it means all along, they knew the saboteurs and they played along. That is the dereliction of duty.
Because if their hands were tied and there was nothing they could do, so they probably they want to stop living with
my
their
sister,
guilt.
Their
and
hands cannot
to come
be,
out now.
Their hands no, cannot be tied that they cannot exercise their constitutional
responsibility.
That was
why
they were
there.
What if they are there?
Let's take this call.
Okay.
Good morning, Emeka.
Good morning.
Good morning, Emeka.
Good morning, is this CROSSFIRE?
Yes,
yes,
please.
Okay. Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is from Enugu.
All right.
Yes, Buhari is doing well for now. But we cannot say that he will probe only Goodluck Jonathan.
Okay.
Okay.
Because it's not only in the regime of Goodluck Jonathan that there is corruption. Like our man there said, there is Halliburton case. There are cases. We spent $16 billion on NEPA, PACN alone, under Buhari's government, and under the Obasanjo's government. What has been of that money? So when we get all these things, anyone we get, we deal with it, and it goes.
All right.
He's a good driver. Let him drive us. But if he allows people around him to be telling him, go this way or go that way, it will not be better, because these are the same people that have been in government, that have put us, turned us into this place. It is about their interest. President Mechi did not pay salaries for 2 months. And now he is a friend. 2 months. It's in the Niger Delta. They have oil money. Why will he be owing 2 months' salary? Then in the Osun State, APC State, they are owing 8 months. In Imo State, if their policies are okay, why are those people suffering?
Yeah. All right.
You work and you are not paid. So let him continue sanitizing, but let people around him, are corrupt too.
All right.
We have to go now, Emeka.
Thank you so much, Emeka.
Thank you.
But there's something I also need to state.
Let's quickly take this last call, Ishoma. Right. Hello, good morning.
Hello.
Good morning.
Hello, welcome, good morning, Bakari.
Yeah, good morning. Let me begin like this. I give kudos to you guys over there for, the wonderful job you are doing.
Thank you.
This is a great show of, patriotism on your side.
Thank you very much.
And let me also begin like this, the analyst that you brought on, the program, maybe you will buy a proverb that said, Kadeba Subu and Wadu, and Tadalagbata Subu and Lomawu. It's only by knowing where we are coming from, and we're able to lift ourselves out of this, security predicament that we find ourselves.
Yeah.
Those two, big chiefs in the army, kind of minimal, who made this statement without any prompting at all, then much is left to be desired. It means if they are actually picked up and proper interrogation is done, we'll be able to get more from them that will actually help us to reimagine our military the way they're supposed to be, even our security at large.
That's true.
Because any country that is not able to provide two basic things that a good government is supposed to provide cannot be said to be suffering, namely security and welfare.
Mm-hmm.
Any other thing that you want to, categorize will fall under these two broader classifications. So what I'm trying to say in essence is that these two people, not as a matter of punishment or, witch hunting, let these people be caught. There is still more for them to see without, without any, I don't know whether you're following me.
Yes.
They have said what they have said.
Mm-hmm.
It means if they are called, there is still more for them to see, so that we can actually get more facts on how we want our military to be.
Exactly.
So that we can save that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so very much, Bakari, for your contribution. Now, on the last note, let's look at this. In your opinion, in the public opinion, a pro-Nigerian, what do you think President Buhari should do to the outgone, to the retired service chiefs?
Well, what I think President Goodluck Jonathan should do, President Muhammadu Buhari should do to the ex-service chiefs is that they should be arrested. You see, these people not only violated the constitution, they also committed treason.
Mm-hmm.
They forced INEC to postpone an election. It has never happened in our political, and it is a bad precedent. We have to send a signal to people coming behind us that you don't commit illegality in a country that is built, that the foundation is built on the rule of law or a government.
Mm-hmm.
We were supposed to have an election. These guys forced the postponement of the election for 6 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So you want
they
to
held
ask,
the nation to ransom.
They held the nation to ransom. This is the same man. These same people that held the nation to ransom are the same persons coming on air to tell us that some people were sabotaging the fight against terrorism.
It's an unfortunate
And they were placed at the helm of affairs.
Yes.
They had resources at their disposal to make sure
they had everything.
In fact, they called the shots.
They called the shots. So it shows you that these are the greatest enemy of the Nigerian people. And for us to send a warning signal to other members of their group, still in our military or in other facets.
And even the newly appointed.
And even that, look, if you.
Your testimony must not be like this by the time you are leaving the office.
Yes. Of this compromise, this corrupt, this unprofessional leadership of the military has never had it this bad.
Very true.
It means that these service chiefs compromise national security. They should be charged to the ICC for crime against humanity. Because the number of officers we lost to the terrorist battle, as well as Nigerians and properties, it means they know more than they are telling us. So unless,
and
like the last caller said,
and they should come out to tell us the elites.
In regional,
yes,
it means they have
they should tell us the elites because me, I don't know. I don't have that information.
I don't have that.
He has the information. That's why he said it.
Okay,
he's in a vantage position to disclose to Nigerians,
okay,
so that we can get this thing settled
once
and
for
all.
Because if this information does not, you know, become
we don't
a
get
public
to the root
consumption.
Of it.
It may make it very difficult for the newly elected service chiefs.
It will be helping
the
society. Sure. Okay. So it should be arrested with their commander in chief as well.
Okay.
They should be questioned.
All right.
If you like, call it probe. But
whatever it's
whatever, but they must be called to give account and to expatiate on their statement.
For me, most importantly,
thank
Nigerians
you.
Should also rally behind the president and support him to cleaning our nation.
Yes, definitely.
Thank you so very much, Nelson Ekujumi. This is
thank
our
so
weekend.
Thank
go
you.
On Crossfire today. We'll be back tomorrow for another very interesting episode. Do join us.
Say no to violence.
So, did you like what you just saw? I know you did. It's very simple. If you want to see more, just subscribe to our channel right now.